How's it going, guys? I'm back again, of course. My name is David. You should know me by now. If not, if you're new, welcome. Today is my final installment, part 5 of my I Love Sandalwood series. Now, I don't know if you could tell, but I'm extra hairy today. I actually, for this shave, the grand finale of the series, I got about 4 or 5 days of growth on my face. And the reason why I did this is because today I'm using a soap that I truly believe can handle the task. Today, I already gave you guys a little preview of it in the last video. If you haven't watched that, go back and watch it first. But if you're already here, you're already determined on watching the video now, Petal Pushers Fancies. Petal Pushers Fancies is going to be the grand finale of my I Love Sandalwood series. The reason being is, out of the sandalwoods that I do have, it is arguably the best performing soap, sandalwood soap that I have. Petal Pushers Fancies is also this month's Wet Shaver Review Vendor of the Month. So you guys know already that I mentioned quite often Razor and Brush. I'm part of the Shave the Man. I'm over here dropping stuff. But out of all of the groups that I am a part of, there are the big three that I really am involved with: Razor and Brush, Shave the Man, and Wet Shaver Review. Wet Shaver Review is full of a bunch of great people, and they have decided to make Petal Pushers Fancies the vendor of the month for the month of October. Petal Pushers Fancies just came out with about 2 or 3 brand new scents to their lineups. Some of you guys are pretty familiar with them, especially since they're pretty much like in cahoots with How to Grow a Mustache, Synergy Safe Soap. You'll see their soaps offered on their website. I do believe they also have their own website, so you can go check them out. And I just love the performance of the soap. It's a solid soap. It's one of the soft, solid soaps, I guess you could say. It comes in one of these nice tins. This is one of the smaller tins. Able to push that in there, make sure it sticks in there real nice. I already lathered up my brush and everything. I am back to board. So, Anthony, the Stallion, I am back to board today. So, no reason to worry. We're all set up for a nice, did I say board? I'm sorry, I'm back to I'm back to Badger today. So, we are set. Already loaded up. Okay, so Petal Pushers Fancies, if you guys are not familiar with it, their formula is not, I wouldn't say they're exactly like the Synergy 2.0. I would put them in the same class of soap. They're very similar, but they're not the exact. Great sandalwood scent, and the performance is amazing. Has probably one of the best post shaves out of all the sandalwoods that I have. Great slickness, post shave, ease of lathering, the whole deal. So you already see it's looking pretty nice. I'm kind of making a mess of myself because I did use the Marcos method to lather it up. Today I won't be putting any kind of lather on the mustache area because November is coming up. I am going to try to grow out my mustache for the month of November. It doesn't grow in evenly, unfortunately. This side grows in darker than this side. And I haven't let it grow out for some time. So I'm going to see if maybe it may grow out a little bit more even. I would like to have the mustache going on for November. But no telling whether it's going to work out or not. So you can see plenty of lather left in still in the brush. Great stuff. Sandalwood, man. I've been on this sandalwood kick and I absolutely do not regret it. It's been amazing. I've been using a bunch of sandalwood. I still have more in my repertoire. One that I need to get is that Straight Razor Designs sandalwood. I keep hearing good things about it. Even Anthony said in his last video he was considering using that soap. I'm not gonna get too close to the mustache because I don't wanna accidentally cut some of it off, so. I'm I'm gonna attempt to be smart at this. Now I can really hear the hair, so it's obvious that I have a lot more hair than usual. Usually, regardless on even if it's a hollow ground, I usually don't hear the hair this loud. My Boker King Cutter is probably my most audible razor, and you usually don't even hear it this loud, but my whiskers are long today. And this soap is going through them like nothing. In case you're wondering, I'm using my Restore Class razor. Great shaver. Once again, this isn't the first straight razor I've ever gotten. Sorry if my hand's in the way right there. Again, I want to be real careful. I don't want to cut any of the mustache off because then I'm going to have to cut the whole damn thing off. So. Today's Sunday. I want to apologize. I didn't shave for Stallion Day. Stallion Day was on Friday, and I had a varsity football game that I had to be at. Coaching for the program, I had to make sure to be there. But Anthony, hey, congratulations on having a day particularly for yourself. You're a real important part of the community we have. You're incredibly generous with the advice you give people. You always have good conversation, always have positive views on damn near anything that we discuss. And, you know, you deserve it, brother. So, you know, I'm happy that you had your day. Funny enough, in my second and third passes, I actually feel like this soap gets better. It feels nice and dense, rich. It feels great right now. The Sandalwood is the only scent that I have from Petal Pushers Fancy. I hear their new scents are amazing, and also their black tea. So I'll probably be getting those sometime in the next month. There's just been so many damn soaps that I've been wanting that there's almost not enough time for all of them. So, but I will get around to it. I think I seen her name. I think her name may be Fancies. She's been a little bit more active in the groups this past month or so. So happy to see her there. If I messed up your name, I apologize. I may have forgotten it. I am absolutely burnt out today. This past week I worked 7 days, and these last 2 days were both over 10-hour days. So I'm a little bit tired. I was actually asleep. I knocked out. But I had told Aaron Schechter, one of the big cheeses over from Wayshare Review, that I was going to do this video, and I didn't want to disappoint. So I make sure to get up and take care of business. I just needed it. I was starting to itch. My neck hair just totally bugged me. My wife thinks I'm just being a spoiled brat that I want to shave every other day, but after that second day, my face really starts to itch. Not so much my face, my neck. It's like my neck can't handle having the hair anymore. Back when I had cartridge razors, I swear I would shave only when I absolutely had to. So sometimes I would shave like once a month. I really just hated it. Now I've gotten my face so used to shaving. Every other day drives me nuts when I can't. So, in the last few videos, I've gotten into the habit of not watching my videos before I post them. And I posted my last video. And I noticed that, like, through the whole damn video, I'm doing, like, the pee-pee dance. You see a lot of walking back and forth. My camera's in and out of focus and stuff. So, I'm really trying to stand still. Probably because still during, like, I'm still not completely comfortable with all the quiet time in between my discussion topics. So like when I'm not talking, I actually still get a little bit nervous because I just feel like, oh man, I'm gonna lose their attention and they're not gonna want to watch my videos. But I just gotta learn to relax. This shave is flying by. I'm already on my third pass. Amazing shave. And even for the occasion, I wore a purple shirt. I used my purple razor. All because Petal Pusher's Fancies has purple in their label a little bit. So I was like, I had a dress for the occasion. Even though I'm not all fancy, I had to prepare. Plenty of soap still left in the brush. Go ahead and grab some of that and apply it to the cheeks. Oh yeah, that's good stuff. Oh, and to Busta, I was watching the video you did for the Stallion, and when you're shaving your chin, man, I seen that little angle you took. You were cutting about right here, and I seen you slide down, and I knew you were going to cut yourself. I even cringed a little bit. I was hoping it wasn't too bad, which it didn't look to be too bad, but I'm curious just to know how bad was it. So let me know when you have to, if you watch this video, comment below. Let us all know how that cut went, because... Yeah, I felt it. As soon as I seen you gonna use that little downward motion, I was like, ooh. So I was scared you're gonna cut yourself, and you got you. You know, but don't worry, happens to the best of us. Make sure my hands are nice and dry. I'm gonna go with my across the grain path. I don't know if I mentioned in the last video or not, but I actually try to do my against the grain pass like Anthony does, which is with the same hand as the side you're going to shave, going up this way. That was extremely difficult. I'm going to try it again, but I might give it a little bit of a chance. I didn't cut myself, no nicks, but I was slow as hell doing it. So I will try it again, but it was hard. So again, I usually use my opposite side hand and go across this way. Yeah, Anthony does it this way, and that was pretty damn hard. And I don't even have thick hair. So, Anthony, you are a true artist with that razor, because I can't handle it. Not to toot my own horn, but I'm actually not too bad or straight, so. Wonder what's the best angle for you guys to see the blade angle on this, maybe like this? I want my videos to be instructional as well as entertaining. So if there's any angles you guys want to see, let me know. You guys be on the lookout too. I have a buddy of mine. name's Edward. He's a music producer. He also does some photography, video editing, and stuff like that. He contacted me. He wants to record one of my shaves. So, Khan, I'm going to give you a run for your money, sir. I will have a high production value video coming up. I don't know what it's going to be of yet, but I'm going to plan something out. Hopefully, it'll be a nice special shave. But I'm going to come at you with some good photo editing and video editing from a buddy of mine. May actually be a video that's on my actual camera, not on my phone. Tell you what, it was nice being back with a boar today. I mean, not a boar, a badger brush. I don't know why I keep mixing up the two, but it felt nice. It worked in the leather great. This shave was pretty amazing. Felt really nice. And I guess one of the advantages of me doing one of my this shave as late as I am doing it right now, my dogs aren't barking. You know, it almost isn't a video without one of my dogs barking. But they're actually knocked out right now. So it's kind of nice. And the neighbor's dogs are probably asleep, so I don't have to worry about them waking them up. Damn, this is a great shave. Right now, this is about as smooth as I've gotten my neck in a long time with a straight. Again, I can't shave this way with the straight. I just don't have the angles. Maybe if I didn't have my goatee, I could come from here. Because my hair grows in like a circle, I can't get it smooth, but this is about as smooth as I got it. So it's a huge testament to what Petal Pusher's Fancies can do. Great cushions, slick. My face is, man. This soap along with Soap Commander may be my slickest soaps. That's great. So if you haven't tried Petal Pusher's Fancies, try that out. I'm gonna go ahead and go with my witch hazel, of course. Feels great. I'm going to use Club Empanade today. I was dealing with a lot at work today. I was dealing with a lot of barber items and barber supply stuff and all that good stuff. And it just, I love Club Empanade. Busta just did his top five aftershaves. And Club Man would definitely be in my top five. I don't have that many aftershaves. So I'm not prepared to put out one of those top five lists at all right now. But damn it, Pinard will be definitely one of the top ones. Give me a sec. This is it. The legend. This is legendary stuff right here. Love it. Looks like just liquidy stuff, but when you feel it, you feel the, I don't want to say oily, but you feel the lotiony properties of it. Get the nice sting on your face. This is a staple. This should be a staple in any man shaved in. It's amazing. So Club Empanade. Alright guys, so that's my shave. Again, Wet Shave Reviews, Vendor of the Month, Petal Pusher's Fancies. Excellent soap, excellent slickness, cushion, ease of lathering. This was a damn fine shave. This is the last of my I Love Sandalwood. I do still have more sandalwood soaps, so I will be mixing them in, but I just wanted to highlight, give a nice little time dedicated to sandalwoods, because I feel that sandalwoods are underappreciated. They're amazing. You know, with all the complex scents coming out nowadays, some of the traditional favorites are kind of getting put on the back burner. Sandalwood is just absolutely amazing. It's my favorite. It's my wife's favorite to smell on me, so you know that's always a good thing. You know, happy wife, happy life. So that's great. So This is episode 5. That's the end of it. You guys have a good night. It's nighttime over here in California, so you'll be seeing this in the morning. So, hey, good morning to y'all when y'all see this.